Hi guys, welcome back to another video. This is Sarika. I hope you guys are doing well. I'm doing well too. As I always say, if you are new to my channel, thank you for visiting and do not forget to like and share our video. Also subscribe us. In today's video, I'm going to talk about the poverty in India and China. Both China and India are large countries with variation in living standards and income. Probably heard the misconception that China is a poor country despite of being second largest GDP, second largest economy in the world. China is one of the largest and fast growing economies with a strong manufacturing sectors. Its GDP is measured in trillions of dollars and surpassed many of developed nations. Over the past few decades, it has experienced significant growth and development, lifting hundreds of millions of people out of the poverty. One of the significant and commendable achievements in recent history of China is commitment to reducing poverty. China's economic transformation began in the late 1970s when it implemented a series of economic reforms and opened up to international trade and investment. Many years ago, many regions in China faced extreme poverty with millions struggling to meet their basic needs. But the Chinese government took poverty reduction seriously and has made great efforts in reducing poverty and improving living standards for many of its citizens. They integrated a series of targeted policies and initiatives aimed to improving the living standards of people. They have invested heavily in building a network of high-speed railway, modern airport and smart cities, connecting it regions and expanding global influence. These initiatives include investment in infrastructure, healthcare, education in rural areas. As a result, hundreds of millions of people have been lifted out of poverty in China, significantly improving their living standards. Let's have some of example. In regions like Guizhou and Yunnan, government official and community leaders have worked hand in hand to identify those in need and provide targeted assistance. It's just not about lifting people out of poverty, but also about creating sustainable change. Old villages have been transformed with new homes, schools, and healthcare facilities. Infrastructure development has been a game changer. Improved transportation links have connected remote villages to markets, making it easier for people to sell their goods and access resources. Education also plays an important role in breaking the cycle of poverty. China has provided scholarship and initiative for students in this area, ensuring that education is accessible to all. Healthcare is another priority. Mobile medical team reach remote areas, offering vital service to those who had limited access to healthcare previously. E-commerce also a game changer in reducing poverty in China. Rural entrepreneur can use online market to sell their products, reaching wider market and boosting their income. These are just some remarkable example of China toward reducing poverty. Now let's talk about the poverty in India. India is characterized by a diverse landscape with a mix of urban and rural areas. India has experienced substantial economic growth in recent decades. It is one of the fast-growing major economies globally. India has attracted significant foreign investment, indicating confidence in its economic potential. Poverty rates vary across the state. Some regions may have high poverty rate and some may have low. Government has implemented poverty alleviation program, also social initiative to address these challenges. India has made progress. It is important to acknowledge that there are still many people continue to face economic challenges and has significant population living in poverty, especially in rural and less developed regions. Efforts to reduce poverty and improving standards are ongoing. Government has launched various initiatives to reduce poverty. For example, improving infrastructure and enhancing education and healthcare. Manufacturing industries and large consumer base making it an attractive destination for investment and business opportunities. However, it still faces a number of challenges. Let me highlight few of the points. That one is underemployment, where individuals are not able to find job that match their skills and qualifications. Many people have to work in low pay, and it is a significant issue in India. Other one is historical factors. India has a long history of colonization and foreign rule, which had a lasting impact on its economic development. Other one is income inequalities. Income inequality is a significant issue in India. There is a gap between rich and poor. The gap is like if people are rich, they are very rich. If people are poor, they are very poor. And some people are middle class. They are not rich and they are not poor. So it's just middle class people. Other one is inadequate infrastructure. Inadequate infrastructure, including transportation, energy and healthcare facilities, has been a hurdle of economic growth and development in many parts of country. Some areas also have education and skill gaps. Access to quality education is uneven, and there's a need to bridge the gap in skill required for modern industries. One of the thing is corruption. Corruption is obstacle to economic growth and foreign investment in some areas. India is a country of contrast with both economic challenges and achievements. It is essential to recognize its diversity and complexity rather than simplifying it as a uniformly poor. Many people will comment, I am telling negative thing about India. No, it's not negative. It's just area of improvement where we need to focus. So here my point is not to say anything bad. I just want to highlight the things need to be improved for economic growth so that people can have a good life. My objective to make this video is to highlight the points where we need improvement. Like China is a good example for reducing many of people out of poverty. That's the reason I have highlighted the good thing about China. They are doing good for their people. So yes, we can see and we can also improve with this. I'm not saying which country is poor. I'm just highlighting the things which have been done to reduce poverty for many people. Of course, there are challenges here in China. Of course, there are challenges in other countries as well. No country is perfect. But important thing is how the country try to improve those areas. Guys, what's your opinion on it? Please mention in the comment section. I will wait for your comment. And do love our video, share it with your friends and family. I will see you in the next video. Till then, bye bye.